Basically, in today's class, our third chapter is severe test. I think I am audible. Okay, so so our topic is severe test. So basically, we have discussed so many times about the severe test. So these are some of the notes which you can refer. I am not going to the detailing of that note, because basically the severe test we have already discussed in the class in the labs. So let us concentrate on some problem regarding the severe test. So see the problem. The following are the load values obtained corresponding to the recommended values of penetration from a CBR test on a subgrid soil sample. Calculate the CBR value. So how you are going to calculate? First, there will be load versus penetration graph. In that curve, you will observe whether any correction for the CBR curve is needed or not. If no correction is needed, in that case, CBR for 2.5 mm penetration would be your 19.5 load divided by 1370 into 100%. And CBR at 5 mm penetration would be 38.7 divided by 2055 into 100%. So the maximum one would be your CBR value. Okay, so you just calculate the problem. First, you have to draw the load versus penetration curve. So basically, here it would be penetration. And here it would be load. In the y-axis, it would be load, and in the x-axis, it would be penetration value. Okay, so accordingly, you plot one graph. So after plotting the curve, if the shape of the curve is like that, in that case, it is okay. Now, what happens in some cases, the curve may look like this. Okay, one convexity may be there. So if there is some convexity, in such cases, what you have to do? You have to draw one tangent over there, and it will intersect your x-axis at certain point. Okay, it will intersect your x-axis at certain point. So initially, whenever you are plotting your curve, then zero was that mark. Okay, if any correction is required, in that case, your zero line would be shifted over there. So if your zero is shifted, so all the points would be shifted in that direction only. Okay. Accordingly to this distance, all these points would be shifted. So if there is correction, in that case, find out what is the corrected value for the 2.5 mm and 5 mm load values, corrected load values, if any correction is required. Now, if no correction is required, in that case, for your 2.5 mm penetration and 5 mm penetration, the load values are 19.5 and 38.7. Now, severe value, there will be two severe values. Severe value वैल्यू एट 2.5 mm पेनिट्रेशन एंड सीवियर वैल्यू एट 5 mm पेनिट्रेशन. सो सीवियर वैल्यू एट 2.5 mm पेनिट्रेशन वुड बी लोडेड 2.5 mm दैट इज 19.5 डिवाइडेड बाय स्टैंडर्ड लोड. स्टैंडर्ड लोड इज 1370 केजी. 1370 केजी. So divided by 1370 into 100%, that would be your CBR value for 2.5 mm penetration. Now for the 5 mm penetration, your CBR value would be loaded 5 mm penetration, that is 38.7 divided by standard load at 5 mm penetration, that would be 2055. And that total thing multiplied by 100. After that, find out which CBR value is maximum. Generally, CBR value for the 2.5 mm penetration should be higher. Okay, so which one is maximum? That would be your CBR value. Can you do this? Can you do this? Is it clear to you? So let's solve another problems. Okay, I'm showing you the calculation. Once solved example is there, I'm showing you the calculation. That calculation portion is easy. We have already discussed this in your lab also. So I'm showing it again. So see, that is another example. These are the penetration and these are the load values. Okay. So these are the penetration and load values. You have to find out what is the CBR value. So from that load versus penetration, you have to plot one graph like that. Okay, here it would be load and here it would be penetration. I think that picture is not so much clear. Just if you can notice over there, if you can notice over there, just check, okay, one small correction is there. And see, all these points have been shifted to some extra points, some other distance. Now, if it is shifted, in that case, you have to find out what is the new 2.5 mm penetration and 5 mm penetration. So for this example, see, if you plotted all these lines, in that case, initially your 2.5 mm penetration was this, okay? But after shifting, your 2.5 mm penetration is this one, okay? Similarly, before shifting, your 5 mm penetration line was this one, but after shifting, your 5 mm penetration line is this one. Okay, so initially, what was your 2.5 mm load for 2.0 corresponding to 2.5 mm penetration load? It would be like that. If you draw one line, in that case, initially it was like that. So it will be somewhere like this, okay? So similarly for the 5 mm penetration, that was your initial one, and after you modify the curve, after you correct the curve, your next point changes to that point, okay? That's why you need to plot that graph to check whether any corrections are required or not. Now, if there is correction, you have to find out what is the corrected 2.5 mm load corresponding to 2.5 mm penetration and load corresponding to 5 mm penetration. Now, if no correction is required, or after the correction, what you will do, you will find out what is the severe value. Now, the severe value, definition for the severe value is load at 2.5 mm penetration divided by standard load into 100%. Okay, so your severe value at 2.5 mm penetration would be load at 2.5 mm penetration divided by your standard load into 100%. And your severe value at 5 mm penetration would be load at 5 mm penetration divided by your standard load into 100%. Now this 1370 and 2055, these are the standard load for 2.5 mm penetration and 5 mm penetration. Okay, after this, you multiply this with 100 and make it a percentage value. So your severe value at 2.5 mm penetration is 1.78%, and severe value for the 5 mm penetration is 2.02%. Now, another thing is, generally, the severe value for the 2.5 mm penetration should be higher than of the 5 mm penetration. But in this case, what you are observing, that the severe value at 2.5 mm penetration value is lesser than the severe value of 5 mm penetration. So in such cases, what you have to do, you have to repeat the test. Okay, now after three times of repetition, if similar type or similar kind of results have been observed, in such cases, you have to adopt the maximum severe value, maximum one, as your corresponding severe value for the soil subgrade. Now check whether these calculation portions are clear or not. I've shared the note in your WhatsApp group. Now tell me whether it is clear or not, that calculation portion. Or I have already shared this note in your WhatsApp group. You can have a look into that thing. After that, you can get a clear idea about it. Okay, sir, can you tell how to get the 1370? Okay, 1370, as we have already discussed in our lab classes, 1370 is the standard one. It is a standard load. Okay, so basically CBR test was developed by California Division of Highways. Now what happens, they tested this CBR for the soil upgrade. Now basically CBR test is a relative strength of the soil. Now whenever we are calculating that relative strength, in that case that strength should be in comparison with some other strength. Okay, so basically that 1370 is the CBR value for the crushed particle or crushed stone. That is a value for the crushed particle or crushed stone, okay, which that California Division of Highways have previously used. From that you will get that value 1370, and not only 1370, 1370 and 2055 kg. So 1370 is basically your standard load for 2.5 mm penetration, and your 2055 kg is basically your standard load for 5 mm penetration. You just go through that note number 5. Okay, I have already shared 3 notes. You go through note number 5 and that problem is there. You just go through the problem. All of you just go through the problem and check whether it is clear or not. If the penetration rate is different and the standard load is also different. Basically, I'm not getting your question. Can you on your mic and say? Yes, if the penetration is different, in that case standard load is also different. So for the see for here, yes, standard load is also different. So see over here, Here for the 2.5 mm penetration, the standard load is 1370, and for the 5 mm penetration, your standard load is 2055. So basically, as the penetration changes, your standard load also changes. Okay, after plotting how that new zero. So here it would be penetration value, and here it would be load value. Okay, so if you have any graph with you, in that case you can also plot. So from the table, whatever table is given, from the table, suppose this is your table. So here, what are the different types of load, different types of data? One is penetration data and another one is load data. Okay, so in one axis you put your penetration values, in another axis you put your load values, and you will find load versus penetration graph. Can you plot this, that load versus penetration graph? Okay, so after plotting, see what happens here. After that plotting, this is the shape of the curve. But here, see over there, there is some convexity portion. Okay, convexity means what happens in some cases. Okay, this is the convexity. In some cases, this type of convexity may appear. So initially your zero line was this one. That was your zero line. You start your graph from that point only. But if you encountered any convexity, in that case, what you have to do at the point of the convexity, that is where that graph changes its directions, over there you have to draw one tangent. Like that. Okay, so if you draw one tangent, that tangent will intersect with the x-axis at some point. Okay, so that point would be your new zero line. So suppose initially, so that is your zero line. Now suppose initially that is your zero, and this point was your okay 2 mm penetration. But after you transfer this point to zero, your 2 mm penetration would be transferred to this point. Okay, so basically in this way all these points will be transferred to another point. Okay, now after that, what you have to do, you have to find out what is the new 2.5 mm and 5 mm load corresponding to 2.5 mm and 5 mm penetration values. So if initially it was 2, suppose over here let me show you, suppose here it was 2.5 mm penetration line. In that case, your load at 2.5 mm penetration would be this one. Okay, but after you transfer this, suppose now new 2.5 mm penetration line is this one. So your new 2.5 mm load would be this. So your load value will also change as you correct the graph. Okay, so after correcting the graph, you will get to know your load values for the 2.5 mm penetration and 5 mm penetration. After that, you will go to the formula for the CBR value, and you can directly find out what is the CBR value for 2.5 mm penetration and CBR value for 5 mm penetration. You got it? So if you got it, in that case you draw this graph. Okay, you have all this data. I have already shared this to you. Just draw this graph, and in the next class just show me that what type of loads you are getting. Okay, in that case it would be very much clear to you. Okay, so all of you in the next class just go to with this problem and draw the curve. Okay, draw the curve, and if there is any correction, do the correction. This example is already there. You just have to draw the curve, and if there is any correction needed, you need to correct this. Okay, in our previous class we have discussed about another test, that is plate load test. Okay, how that plate load test is conducted, that we have already discussed. So that is another problem related to plate load test. So from the plate load test, what are the factors we have to find? That is the modulus of subgrade reaction. It is called modulus of subgrade reaction. Now, the modulus of subgrade reaction, or K value, the modulus of subgrade reaction is denoted by K. Okay, so modulus of subgrade reaction of soil tested with a 350 mm diameter rigid plate is 5.25 MPa. Okay, if MPa is there, in that case millimeter is not required. 5.25 MPa. Estimate the modulus of subgrade reaction when a plate of diameter 750 mm is used instead. So if you use the 350 mm diameter plate, in that case you will get that modulus of subgrade reaction value of 5.25. But the question is, what would happen if you use a 750 mm diameter plate instead of 350 mm diameter plate? So let us go for the first portion of the problem, then you go for the second portion. So how you can find it? So basically there is a formula. If there is two sizes of plate, so different sizes of plate, that is discussed in your previous class, and that formula is there also in your lecture number 2. So that formula is basically your K1 into D1 equal to K2 into D2. Okay, so this is the formula. So where K is the your modulus of subgrade reaction, D is the diameter of the plate. So here your diameter of the plate for which that we have already got the data is 350 mm, and what is the K1 value? That is 5.25 MPa per mm. Okay, so your K1 multiplied by D1, that is 5.25 into 350. Now, what you have to find out, what is the corresponding modulus of subunit reaction value for 750 mm diameter plate. So, that is K750, that is what is that value we have to find out, this value we have to find out, and the diameter of the plate is 750. So, from simple calculation, you can find out what is the modulus of subunit reaction value for 750 mm diameter plate. So see this next example. That example is very important. A plate load test was conducted on a soaked subgrade during monsoon season using 30 centimeter diameter plate. The load values corresponding to mean settlement dial readings are given below. Determine the modulus of subgrade reaction for 70 centimeter diameter plate. So basically in this example, what you have to find out, first you have to find out what is the modulus of subgrade reaction for 30 centimeter diameter plate. After that, you have to convert that modulus of subgrade reaction value into 70 centimeter corresponding to 70 centimeter of diameter of the plate. So here mean settlement values and load values in kg are given. So that load values are basically whenever there is some settlement, like suppose for 0.24 mm, in that case your corresponding load value was 460 mm, like severe test. So after that, first you have to find out what is the load versus settlement graph. So basically that is your load versus settlement curve, where your x-axis is basically your settlement and y-axis represents the load, like in the severe test. After that, the load value P1 corresponding to mean settlement value of settlement 0.125 centimeter is determined, which is 1490 kg. How they determine this? So from this curve, you plot all this curve, and after plotting this curve, you have to find out what is the corresponding value for 1.25 centimeter or 1.25 centimeter of the corresponding load values, or 0.125 centimeter. 1.25, here all these things are in millimeters. So if you convert this into millimeter, it would be 1.25 millimeter. So from the curve, you can easily find out what is the corresponding load values for 1.25 millimeter. So how you are going to find out, that is one. Suppose this, that is your 1.25. If it intersects over there, okay, so basically that corresponding load is your corresponding load value for 1.25 millimeter of the settlement. Now why 1.25 millimeter of the settlement is considered? Because for the plate load test, that penetration value or that settlement value is considered as standard one. So that is 1490 kg. Now what is the unit pressure? So your unit pressure would be that kg 1490 divided by your area of the plate. So initially that plate size was, diameter of the plate was, what is the diameter of the plate? 30 centimeter. So your area would be pi into r square. So that would be kg per centimeter square. Now modulus of subgrade reaction for 30 centimeter diameter plate would be your that one, that is the unit pressure divided by your 0.125, that is the settlement. Okay, so basically, if you go for the definition of the modulus of subgrid reaction, then the modulus of subgrid reaction K is the unit pressure divided by that delta or that mean settlement value. Okay, so here for your mean settlement value is 0.125 centimeter. So basically, that is your settlement or modulus of subgrid reaction value for your plate size of 300 mm or 30 centimeter. Okay, now from this, you can easily find out what is the modulus of subgrid reaction for 70 centimeter diameter plate using that formula K1 D1 equal to K2 D2. And from that, you can find out your modulus of subgrid reaction value for 70 centimeter diameter plate is 6.75 kg per centimeter cube. Okay, so basically, what happens if you fraction this, in that case, it would be 6.75 kg per centimeter square. Okay, per centimeter square, and another centimeter would be left. Now kg per centimeter is basically Pascal, and what another centimeter was left, so basically it would be 6.75 Pascal per centimeter. So I'm again discussing this numerical. So in this numerical, basically that data for the load versus settlement curve is given. Okay, and that data is for basically for the 30 centimeter diameter plate. You have to find out what is the modulus of subgrid reaction for 70 centimeter diameter plate. So first, what you have to do, first you have to find out what is the modulus of subgrid reaction for 30 centimeter diameter plate. Now the definition of the modulus of subgrid reaction is unit pressure divided by that settlement. Now for this reason, you need to find out what is the pressure at that standard settlement value. Okay, and your standard settlement value is 0.125 centimeter or 1.25 millimeter. So first you have to plot one graph, that is load versus settlement graph. From that load versus settlement graph, you have to find out what is the corresponding load values for that unit settlement values, that is 1.25 millimeter or 0.125 centimeter. Okay, after finding this, you have to find out what is the unit pressure. So your unit pressure would be 1490 divided by pi into r square. Here r is your 15 centimeter. Why 15 centimeter? Because the diameter of the plate what you have used, that is 30 centimeter initially what have you used. Okay, so after that, you will get your modulus of subgrid reaction by dividing that unit pressure with that standard load, that is 0.125 centimeter, and you will get this. Okay, so after you getting the modulus of subgrid reaction for 30 centimeter diameter plate, then you have to find out what is the modulus of subgrid reaction for 70 centimeter diameter plate using the formula that was K1 D1 equal to K2 into D2. Is it clear? Is it clear? Okay, I'm taking the attendance. After that, you can leave. Okay, you can leave.